Women Heroes of the Philippines. The landscape of a newly born nation is trodden by the bold footsteps of its pioneers and laden with the blood, sweat, and sacrifices of those who gave up their lives and resources so that future generations may live fully and freely. Dr. Jose Rizal, Andres Bonifacio, Marcelo del Pilar, and Apolinario Mabini struggled and gave their all for a free and independent Filipinas. Many of our heroes were men, but women too were there right from the very start to struggle against the oppressors, lay down the groundworks, and establish the foundation of the country we now call the Philippines. This presentation introduces four of the bravest Philippine women heroes during the fight for Philippine independence against Spain, which began in August 1896 with a tearing by Filipinos of the Cedula certificates in Pugad Lawin or Balintawak, Quezon City, in defiance of Filipino allegiance to Spain. These women heroes are Gregoria de Jesús and Melchora Aquino of Luzon, and Nazaria Lagos and Teresa Magbanua of the Visayas.
Gregoria de Jesús, the wife of Andres Bonifacio, was the founder and vice president of the women's chapter of the Katipunan, a revolutionary society in the Filipinos' fight for freedom from Spain. Gregoria and the women of the Katipunan were the custodians of the documents and seal of the Katipunan. The Guardia Civil searched the homes of suspected Katipuneros. Gregoria would gather the Katipunan secret documents and drive all night around town in a calesa, returning home only when safety was assured. Among the important documents were copies of Kalayan, meaning liberty, the newspaper of the Katipunan, printed from funds earned by Francisco del Castillo and Candido Uban, who won an Australian lottery while working as pearl divers in the later 19th century in the Torres Strait region in northern Australia.
Initially, 29 women were admitted to the Katipunan, among them Josefa and Trinidad Rizal, the sisters of Dr. Jose Rizal. Women served as nurses, spies, helped in the recruitment of new members into the organization, and some became generals and revolutionaries in their own right. Nazaria Lagos, known as Florence Nightingale of Panay, served as the first president of the Red Cross of Iloilo in 1897. Nazaria and her husband Segundo secretly supported the Filipino revolutionaries and would often host the secret meetings of the leaders inside their home in Dueñas, Iloilo province. She became the head of the hospital set up by the revolutionaries in Jagimit, a barrio of Dueñas. She served her position well, solicited medical supplies and manpower from the townspeople. The hospital continued to operate under her supervision up until it was captured and destroyed by American forces during the Philippine-American War.
Melchora Aquino, also known as Tandang Sora, from Matanda or Old, because she was 84 years old when the Philippine Revolution broke out in 1896. Tandang Sora operated a store in Balintawak, now part of Quezon City, which became a refuge for the sick and wounded revolutionaries. She fed, gave medical attention, and encouraged the revolutionaries with advice and prayers. Secret meetings of the Katipuneros were also held at her house, thereby earning for her the names Mother of the Katipunan and of the Philippine Revolution for her contributions. She and her son, Juan Ramos, were present in the cry of Balintawak and were witnesses to the tearing up of the Cedulas. When the Spaniards learned about her activities and her knowledge to the whereabouts of the Katipuneros, she was arrested and deported to Guam.
Not least is Teresa Magbanua, known as the Joan of Arc of the Visayas, for her extraordinary skill and bravery as woman general who led Filipino revolutionaries against Spanish and American forces. Born in 1868 in Pototan, Iloilo, Teresa Magbanua, or Nay Isa, was a schoolteacher. When Philippine Revolution broke out in 1896, Nay Isa became one of only a few women to join the Panay-based Visayan arm of the Katipunan. She, along with her two brothers, joined the Katipunan, where she enlisted under her uncle, General Perfecto Poblador. Magbanua is credited as the only woman to lead troops in the Visayan region during the revolution. She fought in several key battles during the revolution. Among these was the Battle of Bayo Yoting on the 3rd of December, 1898. Teresa's forces fought and defeated Spanish troops in Barrio Yoteng, Pilar Capiz. She led her troops on horseback, thereby earning her the nickname Joan of Arc of the Visayas. While not an active fighter during World War II, Magbanua did what she could to resist Japanese forces during the Japanese occupation of the Philippines, selling things she owned to purchase food and supplies, which she would then give to the local guerrillas. After the end of World War II, she moved to Mindanao to live with her sister Maria in Pagayan, Zamboanga del Sur, where she died in 1947 at the age of 79.